Good morning, children. Today we are going to study domestic income. To understand this concept, we should be able to recall the concept of domestic territory, which I discussed with you in a lot of detail in my previous video. In case you have forgotten, then just go through that video again. So now, what is the domestic income concept? It is the sum total of factor incomes generated within the domestic territory of a country during an accounting year. So two things are very important in this definition. One is factor income, which means only the factor incomes are included in domestic income and not the transfer incomes. While the other concept which is to be remembered is domestic territory. So any factor income that is generated within the domestic territory of the country will be part of domestic income. So how to check whether this is a part of domestic income or not? Simply recall that whether it is part of domestic territory, if any income that is generated, any factor income that is generated within the domestic territory of the country, it will automatically become the part of domestic income. For that, you should remember this diagram, which we did in last video. Now let's do some questions which are generally asked in exam. Look at the first question. Will the following be included in domestic income of India? Give reasons. The question is compensation of employees to the residents of Japan working in Indian embassy in Japan. Now how to check? You have to simply check whether the income generated is factor income, number one. Number two, whether the income factor income generated is part of India's domestic territory or not. So yes, compensation of employees is a type of factor income, but Indian embassy. So check whether Indian embassy, no matter wherever it is located, here in this question it is located in Japan, but anywhere in the world it is located, is it part of domestic territory? The answer is yes. Indian embassy located anywhere in the world is part of India's domestic territory, and hence the income generated in this embassy will be part of India's domestic income. So for this, I'll take you to the diagram which we did in the previous video, where we took an example of Indian embassy located in China and we marked it with a green tick, which meant that Indian embassy is part of India's domestic territory, and hence the income generated within this will be part of India's domestic income. So same in this question also, Indian embassy, simply check Indian embassy. Yes, Indian embassy, you should be able to recall, is part of India's domestic territory, and hence it is part of India's domestic income. Next question. Profits earned by a branch of foreign bank in India. Now just check, the branch of foreign bank, is it located in India's domestic territory? Yes or no? So yes, foreign bank is situated in India, and hence it is part of India's domestic territory. Now I have added something in this diagram. This building is showing Bank of America. Now it is a foreign bank. The branch of Bank of America is located in India. So is it India's part of India's domestic territory? Answer is yes. Except the embassies. Everything except the embassies, the consulates and the military establishments, rest everything, even if it is a foreign company or a foreign bank, is part of India's domestic territory. And hence the profits earned within this bank will be part of India's domestic income. So here the answer becomes the profit earned by a branch of foreign bank in India. You should be able to understand that foreign bank is located in India's domestic territory, and hence it is part of India's domestic income. So answer is yes, because the branch of foreign bank is within the domestic territory of India. Next question. Rent received by an Indian resident from Russian embassy in India. Now simply look at the embassy's name, Russian embassy. Always remember, Any foreign embassy located even within your country will not be part of your domestic territory. Like we did the example of American embassy in previous video. American embassy is not part of India's domestic territory, even though it is located inside India's political boundary. Okay? So same way in this question, Russian embassy is not part of India's domestic territory. Hence, the income generated or the rent received from this embassy will not be treated as part of domestic income. Fourth point. Profit earned by a branch of State Bank of India in England. Now, where is this branch of Indian Bank located? It is located in England, and hence it is located not in India's domestic territory. It is located in the domestic territory of England. So, will it be counted as part of domestic income of India? Answer is no. No, because the branch of SBI located in England is not part of domestic territory of India. Last part, financial help given to flood victims. Now, financial help, any kind of financial help is not at all a factored income. It is simply a transfer income. So, answer is simply no, because financial help is a transfer payment. And you should remember that in domestic income, we include only factor incomes and we do not include any type of transfer incomes. Now, one last example in this diagram. I have made the branch of State Bank of India in China. Now, although it is an Indian bank located in China, is it part of India's domestic territory? No. It is not part of India's domestic territory. It is part of China's domestic territory. Okay, I hope you have understood the concept of domestic income. Anything which is any income, any factor income that is generated within the domestic territory of the country will be part of the domestic income of that country. Thank you.